In addition to designing the basic process control system, process control engineers may also be called on to design alarms. Alarms should be designed with a worst-case scenario in mind. Consider this liquid surge tank that should have a high-level alarm, giving an operator 10 minutes to respond before the emergency shutdown system would take over and shut down the inlet stream pumps. Let's consider that under normal operating conditions, it would not be possible for Q1 to be outside of the range of 10 plus or minus 2, and that Q2 would not be outside of the range of 5 plus or minus 1. These limits might be constrained by the capacity of the equipment to deliver these flow rates. Furthermore, under normal operating conditions, this pump can generate a flow rate of 15 plus or minus 2. Furthermore, let's consider that under normal operating conditions, the tank is half full. This level in the tank will not be considered in our alarm design. We just need to know that the level in the tank is well below the top under normal operating conditions. What value of the liquid level, then, should trigger the high-level alarm to prevent the overflow from occurring within 10 minutes of the alarm being activated? To determine where the alarm should be placed, we need to consider the mass balance on the tank, which can provide for us a maximum rate at which the level in the tank can change. In the worst-case scenario, Q1 and Q2 are at their maximum flow rates, while Q is at its minimum flow rate. That would result in the largest rate of accumulation of fluid in the tank. Dividing the accumulation by the cross-sectional area of the tank, we find that in the worst-case scenario, the tank level rises by 0.176 feet per minute. Therefore, to permit 10 minutes for the operator to respond to the alarm should be placed 1.76 feet below the top of the tank.